Hello again, welcome back to my channel. This is yours truly, Joe Brand. So in this video is I will be sharing to you my inputs in the subject industrial psychology. So hopefully to those students who are currently enrolled for the second semester and then you have a subject for industrial psychology, hopefully you will watch this video till the end. Okay, so I will try to explain this subject to you in a very simple way. So hopefully this video would really help you a lot in your learning journey. So it really means to me if you put your comment or if you subscribe and share my channel. Thank you a lot. Okay, so let's talk about the history of industrial or organizational psychology. Let's have a brief introduction about what is industrial or organizational psychology. So based on research, industrial or organizational psychology is a branch of psychology that applies the principles of psychology to the workplace. Okay, so when you talk about understanding the significance of your employees, the recruitment, the testing, the performance of your employees, the organization, okay, so you are talking about the idea of industrial organizational psychology. Importante kayo ni sila. Why? Because they will try to understand what is really going on with their employees. Happy ba ilang empleyado? Na ba mga difficulties when you talk about their performance? Nag-struggle ba sila? So that is the purpose of understanding industrial or organizational psychology. And it's main or overall purpose is to enhance the dignity and performance of human beings, right? So i-uplift. So ang purpose aning industrial organizational psychology is to uplift the welfare of their employees. Dili ipa-down, right? So para ma-feel nila that they are loved, that they are very important, nga gipangga sila sa isa employer, nga they feel secured, they feel happy while working. So that's the idea of industrial psychology. So take note that there are major fields of industrial psychology or industrial or organizational psychology. The first one is we have the personnel psychology. So when you hear the word personnel psychology, it talks about recruitment. It talks about the selection. It talks about your salary level, your performance, training, your salary, and your evaluating employee performance. So they are considered personnel. They fall under the personnel psychology. Okay, so man ako mag-apply kag trabaho, inigsood pa lang nimo, ang mudawat nimo is ang recruitment, ang personnel. Sila in charge ana. The testing, the job offer. So sila ang mudala ana or mu weigh sa imong performance. And then your performance level, kung need na ba ka i-promote, kung need na ba ka nga tagaan og higher salary because of your performance. So it falls under the personal psychology. So the second branch of field of industrial psychology is the organizational psychology. So the focus of organizational psychology is they talk about employee motivation, they talk about job satisfaction, malipayon ba akong empleyado, motivated ba akong empleyado, or naabay kagubot, conflict. They talk about how to address conflict, the conflict management, or the group process. So ilahang focus is the organization as a whole. Ang ilang focus is they try to understand unsa ni nahitabo sa organization, ang mga empleyado, are they satisfied, are they happy? So it falls under the organizational psychology. Okay, the third one, the third field, major fields of industrial psychology is the human factor or ergonomics. Okay, when you talk about the human factor is they concentrate on the workplace design. So, mga safe pa ba ni nga office? Wala ba yung mga problema? Ang ilang focus is the physical fatigue and stress. Okay pa ba mo trabaho ang mga empleyado na ko diri? Unang usahay, tanawon po na ang lingkuranan? okay ba ang gilingkuran sa akong mga empleyado? So it falls under the idea of human factor and ergonomics. Kaya kung dili, kung inyong tan-awan, kung dili safe ang imong gitrabahuan, sometimes you are not comfortable doing your job. You are scared of doing your job because you feel that you are not safe, you are not secure. That's why dapat na aning field of industrial psychology ang human factor or ergonomics. Okay, so hopefully nasabtan. Hopefully you were able to grasp the major fields of industrial or organizational psychology. So if hapit na kamu graduate, no, you really need to understand the idea of industrial psychology because part of your goal after graduation is to find a job, is to find a good working environment. So you need to understand a very brief understanding about what is really industrial or organizational psychology. Okay, so let's try to have a quick history. Giunsa di ay asa nagsugod ang industrial psychology. Let's talk about the brief history of industrial or organizational psychology. Take note nga sa unang panahon, di ba? Sa unang panahon, wala pa to yung mga testing, no? Dili pa kayo istrikto. Dawat lang kung dawat. Right? Kaya di pa man kayo to yung nga naka-istrikto ang ilahang kuan dyan. Wala pa kayo ng industrial psychology sa una. Industrial psychology, it made its first impact during World War I. Okay? So diha ning boom ang industrial psychology during the World War I. Nga naman. So, sa unang panahon, balik ka sa historia, sa unang panahon is daghan kay mga soldiers, no, nga gipang recruit, right? World War I man, so daghan sila gipang recruit ng mga soldiers. So, ang ninsud na diha ang mga industrial or organizational psychologists, unsay purpose nila? Kay tungod daghan mo kay nang applying og trabaho during World War I as soldier, so ilang gibuhat is nag-recruit sila, part of the recruitment is naay testing, so naay exam. So gi-exam nila ang tanang mga soldiers, try just to assess kung okay ba ni sila, kung fit ba ni sila, or qualified ba ni sila sa trabaho. Kaya kung ikaw po'y employer, di po'y kaganahan mo hire o someone no, nga dili fit, nga dili competent, nga sa tanaw ni mo dili kaya ang trabaho. So that's why naay screening, naay exam, naay testing, it's part of the recruitment, or it falls under the personal psychology. Okay, so pag testing nila, so duha ilang gigamit nga testing materials sa una. So ang first nga testing material sa una based on research is naa sila gitawag nga the Army Alpha and the Army Beta. Okay, so ang Army Alpha intelligence test ni siya nga gihatag ni siya nga test to those applicant nga kahibaw mubasa, right? They know how to read. So ilang gi-classify kinsa tong kamao mubasa, tagaanog Army Alpha, kinsa tong kahibaw mubasa, tagaanog Army Beta. So kung makapasar ka sa Army Alpha, pwede ka tagaag posisyon nga higher. Adto ka sa mahimo kang officer training, taas imong position level. Kung mupasar po ka sa Army Beta, kung dito ka nintake og exam, adto ka sa infantry. So mura siya, kung makapasar ka sa Army Alpha sa unang panahon, naa ka sa managerial level. Kung makapasar ka sa Army Beta sa unang panahon, naa ka sa mga ubos nga level nga dili pang managerial or supervisory. I compare na to karon, no? So ang ana di ay nagsugod ang testing. For me, it's really important for us to understand unsay di ay maabtan nato when we apply for a job. Take note na andyan na ang testing. Naandyan na yung mga interviews, mga testing. Aside from the interview, testing, unsa pang mga exam. So taghan dyan na siya because they want to assess if you are qualified for the job or not. Okay, so one of the important factor in industrial psychology is conducting research. So if you are an industrial or organizational psychologist, dapat kamao jud ka mag-conduct og research sa imong empleyado. Conducting research entails no nga mag-experiment ka, you are conducting survey. Why you are conducting survey? Because you want to know if ang imo bang, if your employees are still happy with the job that they are performing, because you want to know if they are satisfied with their job working performance or with their salary. That's why you are conducting research, you are proposing something, because the main goal of industrial psychology is to uplift the dignity of their employees, is to help them build their confidence in their own job performance. Kaya nga naman, nga naman mag-research man, because sometimes when we rely on our common sense, manausahay no kung dili ka mag-research, dili ka manginano o sinahitabo sa imong empleyado, kung maghimo lang kang judgment based lang sa unsay imuhang feeling, kung unsa imuhang pagtanaw, sometimes our common sense is wrong. Sometimes, ning judge lang ta, ning hatag ta judgment without analyzing kung sa juy saktong nahitabo. So that's the role of industrial or organizational psychologist. If you are taking the role of an industrial or organizational psychologist, it is your job to conduct research to get to know more of your employees. Okay, so aside from conducting research, ang mga industrial psychologists also, aside from the research, they also need to be aware of the of ethics. Diba? Dapat kung nagtrabaho na ka, dapat kasabot ka kung unsay sakto or dili saktong buhaton sulod sa kumpanya. Because if you are aware of what is good or what is bad, what is the things that we should do and the things that we should not do, nindot imuhang pagpanarbaho. Nindot naay direksyon ang imuhang pagpanarbaho. Take note nga, kung nanaka sa kumpanya, usahay daghan jud kay kag ma-face nga mga ethical dilemma. Usahay maglibog ka kung unsay sakto o dili saktong buhaton. Okay? Take note. Muna giingon nila no nga, wala jud ko ni perfect company. There is no perfect company. Kaya daghan jud tag mga flaws, daghan pa tag things to improve. That's why research or surveys, experiments, dapat naana siya inside the organization, inside the company. Okay. So take note nga kung magtrabaho na ka, you will face a lot of ethical dilemma. Ethical meaning unsay sakto or unsay dili saktong buhaton. Manang usahay, wala mong good. Manang, when you talk about ethics, usahay, depende yun na sa personal value sa tao. So, kung tanaw ni mo, importante na siya nga value para ni mo, maupon na imong dalon. Kung tanaw ni mo, dili na siya importante, maupon na imong ipakita nga dili na siya importante na kung nga values. So, that's why it's quite confusing, no? Kaya nakadepende kung manarbaho na ka, ang imuhang ang mga butang na sakto o dili sakto ni mo, nakadepende na siya kung sa po'y butang nga imong gi-consider nga sakto para sa imuha. Okay, so that is what you call ethical dilemma. Bisan kinsa man siguro nga tao, no, naadyo tayo mga confusion, naadyo tayo kalibog, especially kung first job pa lang ni mo sa industry, inigsood pa lang ni mo, you will experience culture shock, kaila lahi man. You will experience a lot of confusion. Take note that we have two types of ethical dilemma. Na daw duha ka ethical dilemma that we are going to experience when we entered sa usa ka company, when we get involved into an industry nga usahay makaingon ka, ah, mao dinhi ilang gibuhat. Mao dinhi ang sakto o dili saktong buhatan. That's why na ay training. That's why na ay orientation. That's the purpose of industrial organizational psychology, is for you to understand unsay mahitabo, unsa di ay mahitabo diri nga company, unsay ako ang job, unsay ako ang ayan o dili ang ayan buhaton. There are two types of ethical dilemma. We have the type A and the type B dilemma. Okay, naroon na siya mga types. Okay, so when you talk about type A dilemma, okay, so naa siya, may mga type A dilemma, naa siya taas nga kalibog. Okay? Ganong, there is a high level of uncertainty. Nganuman, it's because there is a positive and negative effect kung imo na siyang buhaton. Ganong taas man, kay taas po ang level nga, you need to decide if what you are doing is good or not good for you. So, naasya both the positive and the negative consequences to a decision. For example, unsa man na siya. For example, estudyante ka, right? Kung mo cheat ka, mapasar ka. Kung di ka mo cheat, mahagbong ka. Unsa man siya ang ngayon ni mong buhaton, which is which? Unsa man, magpahagbong ka or dili ka magpahagbong? So there's a high level of uncertainty. Take note, ikaw nalang understand ha. Please try to understand your personal values if what you are doing is right or not good for you. It is your choice. It is your choice. While the type B dilemma is also called rationalizing dilemma. You tend to rationalize, right? Between right and wrong, kung sa juy sakto. Ang type A dilemma, klaro na kaayo no, nga naa siya positive and negative effect if you do this or that. Ang type B dilemma, kani siya, na kaibaw ka nga sakto siya. Kaibaw ka nga, mauni saktong buhaton. But you are still choosing something nga advantage para sa imuha, bisan kaibaw kang sayop siya. Okay, you know what is the right thing to do, but you still choose the other way around. Kaibaw ka nga dili sakto ang imuhang gibuhat, pero gibuhat gihapon siya nimo. So that is the type B dilemma. Ang pag-cheat, dili sakto, right? But imo gihapon gipili ang pag-cheat. So you are experiencing type B dilemma. In any organization, in any... Bisan estudyante pa ka, we all experience the type A and type B dilemma. The type A, you know what is the right or the right and the wrong ones. Kabalo ka na siya positive and negative, that is type A dilemma, klaro sa imo. But the type B dilemma is, you know what is right, but you are still doing the wrong thing. You know the wrong thing, pero imo gihapon siyang gibuhat. Kitanaw ni mo advantage sa imuhang kaugalingon. Okay, so we all experience that thing. So, manang usahay, it all matters. It all boils down to your own personal values. What is really significant to you may not be significant to others. Okay, so I hope nasabta na to ang background, a very quick background about industrial psychology, the history of industrial psychology, the importance of industrial psychology, and what are the dilemmas that we are going to experience when we first entered ourselves in the industry. Okay, so thank you so much for watching. I really hope that you are learning from this video. This is a very quick background lang, that is the introduction about industrial psychology. If you find that this channel really helps you a lot, so please do subscribe. This is our lesson one for industrial psychology. I will be posting more lessons until the end of the second semester. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for helping me share my video and trying to inspire others to also strive more to do better with their own lives. Thank you so much. God bless.